Hello and welcome to this next video on mobile repairing. From this video on, we will try and understand the different faults that can arise in a mobile phone. We will learn how these faults arise and how we can rectify these faults using different tools. As you can see in front of you, you may be able to see different components, equipments and a PCB here. We have a multimeter. Right next to that is a PCB, which is placed on a PCB stand. And on the right-hand side, we have a micro soldering iron, along with the flux and the soldering wire. Now, these are the tools that are usually required when you need to rectify some of the common faults that arise in a mobile phone. In today's video, let's try and understand one of the main faults that normally arise in a mobile phone. This is called a ringer fault. A ringer fault is essentially a fault in the component that plays the ringer sound. Now, the ringer sound could come from multiple sources. It could either be a song that is saved on your mobile phone or in a memory card, or it could be an internal ringer sound that comes inbuilt with your mobile phone software. Now, before you start working on repairing any mobile phone, please ensure that you have all the necessary tools and equipments with you. Without the use of the appropriate tool or equipment, you may not be able to repair a mobile phone easily. The ringer in a mobile phone is a very important component. The ringer is what indicates the owner or the holder of the mobile phone about someone else's call coming in into your mobile phone. Hence, it's important to understand how we can detect a fault in a ringer and how we can replace the faulty ringer if you identify the fault in the ringer. If you are not receiving the ring while somebody is calling you, it's not necessary that the fault could be in the internal components of the mobile phone. There could also be easier ways to check how or where the fault is. First of all, you may want to check the hardware buttons that increase or decrease the volume on the mobile phone. Many a times by mistake, because we keep the phone in our pockets or we place it somewhere, the volume might be completely reduced using the hardware buttons, and that could result in the ringer not playing. So check whether the hardware buttons are completely in a position where the ringer is in full volume. The second problem could be that we may have disabled the ringer option internally in the mobile phone itself using the mobile phone software. This is normally called a silent mode. So you may want to check whether the mobile phone has been put on silent mode by mistake and verify that the phone is on a ringing mode. If these two issues are taken care of, and despite checking these two aspects, if your mobile phone does not ring, then you may need to open up the mobile phone and check the ringer in the PCB. Once you identify that there could be a problem in the internal component, you may need to open the mobile phone. The way we in one of our earlier videos, we have displayed that very clearly and demonstrated that clearly. So ensure that you follow the safety regulations while you are opening it. And once you open it, you may be able to see a small circular or a round device similar to a speaker. In this mobile phone, in this mobile board that you see, you can see that the ringer is very clearly identified using that circular it's circular and round, similar to many other speakers that you may see. These are some of the other ringers that we find in other mobile phones. Most often than not, most ringers are usually circular, and that will help you understand whether that particular component is a ringer or not. The ringer also has a magnet in it. Like any other speakers, it has a magnet in it, and that shows that this is the ringer component that emanates or that gives out the sound whenever somebody is dialing your number or calling you on your mobile phone. Now, in many phones, the ringer and the phone's earpiece may be combined into one single component. It depends on the mobile phone model. So many mobile phone models have separate ringer and a separate earpiece or a speaker for the earpiece. So when you're working on the mobile phone or when you're repairing a ringer fault, you need to check that the component that you're trying to identify or the ringer that you're trying to identify is actually a ringer and not the earpiece. However, nowadays, many mobile phones have one component which acts both as a ringer as well as the earpiece of the handset. Whichever way, please verify the components before you actually replace them or try working on repairing any of them. Now, let's try and understand how we can identify the fault in this ringer and how we can rectify the fault. Now, normally, ringers are tested using the cool testing method or the beep or continuity testing method using a multimeter. The first thing that we'll do is we will try and switch on the micro soldering iron through the main point, and once it's switched on, the micro soldering iron will start heating up. It'll take a few seconds for the micro soldering iron to heat up, and you'll be able to check whether the iron is hot or not by taking the soldering iron and placing it on the tip. If the tip starts melting, the lead or the lead wire that we have, the soldering wire starts melting, it means that the iron is hot. In this case, it's not melting yet, which means the iron is not hot yet. So we'll keep it on and we will wait for it to get hot. In the meantime, you should place the multimeter on the beep continuity testing point and check the beep. You can hear the beep now. Once the beep is heard, we know that the multimeter is appropriate and it's in the right position. And now, let's try and remove the ringer from the PCB to check whether the PCB is working properly. Now, the micro soldering iron is ready. We've checked it by melting the solder and place the tip lightly on the soldered part. This will immediately melt the soldering lead on the component, and this will help you remove the ringer. Once we've removed the ringer, we need to check for continuity by placing the two probes on two wires of the ringer. Now, if the ringer is not working properly, that signifies that the ringer has a problem. And as you can see, we are trying to place it on both the points, but we do not hear any beep. This signifies that there is an internal problem in the ringer, and we will have to replace the ringer with a new ringer. So let's try and pick up another ringer, which is probably a good working ringer, and try and test it first before we place it on the PCB. So we picked up another ringer. Let's try and do the continuity testing on this ringer. Let's place the probes on it to check whether we hear the beep. We are placing one probe. We place the other probe and you can hear the beep. Now we heard the beep, which means that the ringer is perfectly all right. Now we need to solder it back onto the PCB at the appropriate tips. So you can see the two tips clearly where the ringer needs to be placed. Let's take the soldering iron, melt a little bit of lead and place the wires and solder the ends of the ringer in the appropriate places. Please ensure that you are placing the correct points at each of these positions, similar to how we removed it from the ringer. Once we have soldered it, now the ringer is back in position and you can place the PCB back in the mobile and test whether the ringer is working or not. Now the ringer is back in position and we can do a quick check later and verify whether the ringer is working or not. Now while changing the ringer, you will also need to keep a few safety aspects in mind. First and foremost, when you're working with the soldering iron, please ensure that you are keeping the iron tip inside the stand and not keep it anywhere so that it doesn't cause any physical harm. And if you're not using the soldering iron, ensure that you switch it off. Secondly, please ensure that while you are trying to remove the solder, please place the tip only on the soldered lead which is present in the PCB, not on the wire or any other component, because this could damage the other components also. So please ensure that you place the soldering tip exactly at the soldered lead so that it melts and you are able to take the ringer out of the position. Also ensure that you don't pull the ringer while you are removing the ringer from the mobile PCB. So hopefully we hope that you would have understood how we can detect a problem in the ringer and how we can replace the ringer with a completely new ringer. Going forward, we'll keep learning more about these faults in future videos. Continue learning. Thank you very much.